Do you know how to help someone with depression? Recently, I showed you a video providing ideas on how to support someone dealing with depression. If you haven't watched that video yet, you can find it in the link above. However, giving general advice for this situation is not an easy task, mostly because there are many types and severities of depression, and despite this fact, you need to adequate the information and try to make it more understandable and more concise. For this reason, in this video, I want to delve deeper into the recommendations I have already shared. The first recommendation was to get informed about depression. You may be aware that depression is different from normal fluctuations in mood and emotions related to daily life. Typically, it's considered that a person is experiencing depression when for 2 weeks or more, they endure feelings of sadness, irritability, emptiness, among others. And this discomfort also starts affecting other aspects of their life, such as work, school, relationships, family, and friends. The second recommendation was to understand that depression can be prevented and treated. Therefore, the person experiencing this challenge should always seek a specialist. Usually, the initial treatment for depression is psychotherapy. However, the specialist your loved one visits is responsible for choosing the best treatment for their case. Moreover, I want to tell you that receiving initial resistance is possible. That's normal. Don't try to force the situation. The most important thing is that the other person knows that you are there for them. A good way to prevent and treat depression is by establishing routines that help with self-care, such as exercising, maintaining contact with friends, sticking to a routine for eating and sleeping, and as mentioned in the previous video, trying to be in touch with nature. By the way, if you find the information provided here useful, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, like the video, and share it with anyone you think it might find it helpful. As I mentioned in the previous video, the third recommendation was to always be open to dialogue. This is not a time for giving advice, but for listening, accepting and understanding the person's situation without judgment and with open curiosity. We all have opinions about how others should be living, but that's all, they are just opinions. What is needed here is not an opinion, it's your understanding, because we all live different lives. Try to understand the other person rather than giving advice. The fourth recommendation was to try to find an activity that both you and the other person enjoy, ideally involving physical activity and nature. However, here I want to point out that it doesn't necessarily have to be together, especially if you have been dealing with your loved one's depression for a long time and are experiencing also some exhaustion. It is just important that you, as a caregiver, and also the person experiencing depression, are in contact with nature and also engaging with physical activity. In the link above, you can also find another alternative to cope with your emotions using your body and music. The fifth recommendation was to take care of yourself. I won't add anything more here, but it's just important that you also take care of yourself since depression doesn't go away overnight. And just as a bonus, I want to tell you that depression is something the person is experiencing, not the person itself. I particularly like the Black Dog video from the World Health Organization that you can find in the links provided in the reference list, and that might also give you more understanding about how depression is something external, not what the person is. I hope you find the information I am providing here useful, and if that is the case, please like the video, subscribe to the channel, and also share it. Have a good day. Bye bye.